All right, here's what I think it all comes down to. We convert them or they convert us. So many things divide us today. The 2016 election, abortion, socialism, Obama, nationalism, religious freedom, Trump, COVID-19, the liberal media, racism, the government shutdown, free speech, big tech, public schools, the LGBT agenda, save the earth. I could go on and on. The war on truth is in full swing, and battle lines have been drawn on the liberal left and the conservative right. The media and half the country thinks we're idiotic, immoral, or intolerant. Can we really coexist, or does something have to give? I'm David Fiorazzo, and this is Christ and Culture. We're all human beings. We're all made in the image of God, and coronavirus or not, death comes to us all. I know, sobering, right? And if you've given your life to Jesus and believe in his name, you are a Christian first. The Bible says our citizenship is in heaven, but while we're here, we are ambassadors for Christ and need to be loving and patient with others. This is hard to do, especially when people are so easily triggered, defensive, and divided about politics, the Constitution, and Christianity. In a great article by John Zmirak, he writes, quote, "Engorged with all the power it wielded while Obama was in office, along with its total conquest of our media and academia, the left could not accept Trump's 2016 victory as legitimate. You know, the same way the South couldn't accept the victory of Lincoln in 1860 without a single Southern electoral vote." Now, it's clear we're operated under very different rules of engagement. Many seem all too willing to lie, allow the country to suffer, for people to die, and to slander the opposition. Is it even possible for us to come together under the unifying flag of humanity in these divided states of America? Even Christians have taken sides on candidates, party, policy, but these things are fleeting and will fail us time and time again. They aren't going to save America. They aren't going to eliminate all sickness and disease and poverty. They aren't going to change the truth. A virus, think about this, with a 99.6% recovery rate is not the real danger. It's not the real cause of 30 million Americans being unemployed. The 2017-2018 flu season left us with 61,000 deaths. No draconian measures were taken, nor was there induced fear, panic, paranoia, and the hysteria like we have today. Alan West said that America's biggest threat isn't a virus, it's tyranny. He writes, quote, "We know that COVID-19 is most dangerous for those with underlying medical conditions such as hypertension, heart disease, COPD, type 2 diabetes, and obesity. Those Americans over the age of 65 have been the hardest hit. We were told that COVID-19 was different, but for the most part, it's not. It is still a virus that attacks the respiratory system, and America did not respond this way with MERS, SARS, the bird flu, or the H1N1 swine flu, which affected 60 million Americans during the Obama administration." Sadly, this has become about who controls the narrative, about power, who should be president, and about what vision should be enacted for the entire country. We're now hearing that many deaths of Americans are being classified as caused by COVID-19 when there were pre-existing severe health issues. Now, this is all potentially confusing, and it's crazy. But let's not make this about us, about our side, or about politics. It's about the value of every human life. It's about helping your neighbor. It's about liberty and a country with a rich history of God's grace and tremendous blessings. It's also about a nation that needed a wake-up call, one that has rebelled against the living God and creator of all things. Redeem the time, friends, because either way, our days are numbered. Call on the name of the Lord to be saved. Confess your sins. Turn back to Jesus and bring as many people with you as you can. So Yes, we should vote. Yes, we should speak up. We should fight for godly influence. We should stand for life, for traditional family, for natural marriage. We should be vocal and active in church and state, but we should not put all our hope in this life alone. The Apostle John wrote this, "Do not love the world, nor the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. The world is passing away, and also its lusts, but the one who does the will of God lives forever." So America's deeper problem is not about a virus, a biased media, power-hungry governors, or Washington, D.C. We must return to God and point others back while there's still time. God bless you and keep speaking the truth about things that matter.